October 6th, see the magic that's enchanted generations on the big screen.
Can we?
Mario Pony, the movie, rated PG in theaters October 6th.
When you're a kid, the universe revolves around you. Looking back, it was being protected and cared for. Then, one day, you realize that's not true. Because when you're alone as a kid, the monsters see you as weaker. You don't even know that they're getting closer. Until it's too late.
Before you become what you'll be, you start as who you are. The legend continues. Timberland Legends Club. Exclusive drops every month only at Foot Locker.
Come on, don't you want to burn? Well, it's good, right?
Oh shit, are you live?
Well, this is Twitch TV we're doing right now.
What's up, guys? Welcome to Found Flicks and an Ending Explained that I know you have been waiting for, because so many of you have been asking for it already. The new R-rated adaptation of Stephen King's classic It. The movie has had some massive hype going for it, and I'm glad to say that it mostly delivers with a great cast of kids and a more modern horror flavor versus the 1990 miniseries version. So let's dig into the new adaptation, giving a breakdown of the important moments that help explain the end, exploring what we learn about It itself, and also what to potentially expect in the as-of-yet-unconfirmed sequel that continues the Losers Club story as adults. But come on, we all know there's going to be a sequel, because this one is going to make bank! The 2017 film version moves the events from the 1950s of the original to the late 80s, but much of the overall story remains relatively the same. We're in the small town of Derry, Maine. It's up to a group of outcast kids, the Losers Club, to band together to fight an ancient evil that resurfaces every 27 years in their town, the infamous Pennywise the Dancing Clown. And interestingly, this new version is being released exactly 27 years after the 1990 original miniseries version, making Pennywise's return fit in line with his feeding cycle. Quite spooky indeed. Now, Pennywise isn't your typical clown. In fact, he is not a clown at all. Pennywise is just one of many forms the evil force known as It takes. His true form is a mass of destructive orange lights referred to as the Deadlights, which we see referenced via Pennywise's eyes glowing orange, and they also make an appearance at the end. Though It can take many forms, Pennywise is said to be its favorite form, as the somewhat friendly clown appearance helps disguise its true intentions when hunting its preferred victims of children. Because, hey kids, look at the clown! He's gotta be friendly, right? With his crazy eyes there and dribbling all over himself. Yeesh. It exploits the individual victim's phobias and fears, taking the form of a real-life incarnation of whatever they fear the most. Like with Eddie, one of the members of the Losers Club who is a rampant hypochondriac. For him, it takes the form of a diseased, decaying leper, designed to terrify him based on his phobia of sickness. As Eddie describes the leper as basically a walking infection. In the book, it describes the process of scaring his prey as to salting the meat. Essentially, that the more scared his victim is, the more delicious they will taste. And the reason he prefers children is due to their mostly simplistic fears that he can easily take advantage of. There is a ton more to its mythology and its specific characteristics. I'm considering doing a full It creature analysis in order to get it all in there. So let me know if you guys would be interested in seeing that. It has actually been residing in the Derry, Maine area for thousands of years, involved in many of the large violent incidents that occurred there throughout history. And we see reference to some of these when Ben looks at a book on the history of Derry at the library. Every 27 years, it returns to the surface from its stronghold in the sewers under the town to feed on more victims, after which he retreats into a slumber before the cycle occurs again. And it's during its latest feeding cycle where we begin our story. One stormy night, Bill helps his younger brother Georgie construct a paper boat, sending him off to play in the rain. Unfortunately, Georgie's boat picks up too much speed and diminishes rivering the curve and falls into a sewer drain, home to it. After toying with the blade, Pennywise bites off Georgie's arm, dragging him into the depths of the sewers. But this is only the beginning of Pennywise's reign of terror on the town, and he individually pays visits to the other Losers Club members, feeding on their fears. But the kids don't only have it to worry about, as there's also a gang of bullies led by the psychotic, mulleted Henry Bowers to deal with as well. The kids also have individual encounters with his gang, but once they later become united together in the Losers Club, they are able to work together in a momentous rock fight and overpower Henry and his goons. This is the first instance we see that by working together, their power is stronger. Not only are they able to accomplish more together, but they are also able to overcome their individual fears. Eddie stands up to his mom, who has been forcing medication on him he doesn't need, and keeping him trapped inside from the outside world. Or Beverly, who confronts her father, hurting him greatly, as it's heavily implied that he has been sexually assaulted. So unlike before, when they felt like outcasts or losers, now they have each other and are no longer alone and are stronger together. This idea is core to the story, as it's only by working together that they are powerful enough to fight back against it. Hunting after it, they follow a path via the town sewer lines that connect to several of the events in the town's history, and the Losers Club are able to discover where it resides. 29 Nyvold Street. Here, several of the kids have horrifying near-death encounters with it in various forms, like Eddie with a diseased leper, leading to his arm getting broken, and Richie, who is afraid of clowns, finding himself in a room full of clowns. Aw, hell no! Where he is attacked by Pennywise, but saved at the last moment by Bill. Shaken by this experience, the kids feel they aren't strong enough to stop it, even if working together, and the group go their separate ways. But they are forced back together when Beverly is taken by Pennywise, and the group heads back to Nyvold Street to find Beverly and attempt to destroy it once and for all. They descend into the sewers via a well in the house's basement, but before they can make it down, Henry appears now under Pennywise's influence and attempts to kill Mike. Mike gets the upper hand and sends Henry tumbling down violently into the well, and it sure looks like that's the end of the book. In the book, he survives only to be blamed for all the murders in town and does still have a part to play in the adult story. So we'll see if he ends up surviving or not. Deep in the sewers, Beverly awakes, finding herself in the innermost sanctum of Pennywise's sewer lair, where there's a mountain of his victim's belongings stretching towards the sky. And floating around the structure are all the victims Pennywise has recently taken. This whole thing looks awesome and very creepy. Pennywise then puts on a show for Beverly, showing us the dancing clown part of his namesake, doing some extreme dance moves in front of a wall of fire. And Pennywise is a certified dancing machine, y'all. I couldn't find a clip of this part, but I did put together my own interpretation so you get some idea of what I'm talking about. Go roll something like this. It then grabs Beverly, attempting to scare her, but she has already faced down her greatest fear, her father, and so she no longer fears anything, not even Pennywise. Since Pennywise feeds on fear, this is a problem for him, but he assures her you will be scared. Then opens his mouth very, very wide, revealing deep in his throat the deadlights, which hypnotizes Beverly into a trance, causing her to float up into the air amongst the pile of victims' belongings. Elsewhere in the sewers, Pennywise splits up the Losers Club, luring Stan away from the group where he faces his greatest fear, which is a lady holding a flute from a painting.